o'clock, I will take you back to your room, and your masseuse will be right with you.
Oh, God.
You know what I was about to say? I really appreciate this. I don't remember the last time I had a massage. Oh, yeah, it's just been nuts over at the hospital recently, and I've just heard so many great things about this health spa.
Hi, sir, how...
Hello, I believe I have an appointment at 2:30 under the name of Jonathan.
Okay, one sec.
The spa is beautiful, but I don't know about the customer service. Oh, bastard. Shut up. Okay, I'll call you back. Hello, I don't know if it's in the notes or not, but I was wondering if the masseuse could focus on my withers.
I'm sorry, sir, but we don't have any accommodations for you.
Sorry, I don't understand.
Well, you see, our masseuses are familiar with the human form, and you, sir, are a centaur.
I'm any less of a rich person than you.
Sir, I...
You know, ma'am, I am the chief resident in the pediatric ward at Mercy Hospital, which means that I deal with a lot of interns and a lot of horse girls. I had a very tiring day, and I would appreciate a massage.
Yes, but I don't...
I'm not just some free-range palomino who just cantered his way out. You know, I am a financially stable, upstanding citizen of this country. You're getting me worked up.
Aren't you a doctor?
Oh, so now you're gonna corner me like that. Well, I won't have it. I'd like to speak to your superior.
Sir, I am the manager. The only person higher than me is the owner.
Yeah, and we've never seen him.
No.
Until now!
Jonathan. Well, finally, someone who understands.
Yes, I understand how stressful it can be to be among the bodyguards. But there are so few of us who have evolved and acclimated to human society. You always have a place here at the Babbling Brook Health Spa. And I salute your bravery and your courage. Come then, Jonathan. Let's go and give those withers a good rub down.